Hello and welcome to Sharing Your Great Practice. Now this week we're at saltash.net Community School in Cornwall and I'm here to find out how a combination of pigs, chickens and technology have come together in a pupil-led learning project that is really inspirational. These year 8 and 9 pupils are filming their chickens and pigs. It's part of the Recharge the Battery project that was inspired, designed and delivered by students at the school.
The students came to school talking about a couple of TV documentaries they'd seen, and they were very passionate, saying, I can't believe that these types of farming systems actually happen here in this country. And they said, well, actually, they happen very locally to us as well. So they said that we should be learning about these things. I said, if you're that passionate about it, why don't you do something about it? Why don't you create your own scheme of work or school project to do that? So they said, okay, and so how long have we got? So I worked out that we could maybe spare a few hours in between what we were learning as part of the science curriculum, and I just gave them the time to do it themselves.
Oh, it's nice, pupils catering for pupils. We know what the sort of things we want to do, so it makes it a lot more exciting and a lot more interesting, so you get more involved and it will work harder generally because we know it's something we want to do, so it's good.
The original group of pupils researched the pros and cons of intensive and extensive farming techniques. They created videos.
I'm for free-range farming, primarily because the birds get to cover the 5 freedoms which they don't do under an intensive system.
Little did the school realise that 2 years on, after those first pupils devised Recharge the Battery, that it would leave such a powerful legacy for pupils and teachers for years to come.
They developed all the objectives, outcomes, success criteria, assessment methods and things like that, all the resources that a teacher would need to deliver it. They then actually got me to teach the topic to themselves so they could review and reflect on it and then make any changes they felt was necessary. Projects being used within the school, delivering through the science curriculum, but much earlier on, in Key Stage 3 really. So the project that they had was communicated and done to many other students across the school and also some of our primary colleagues.
And to be able to study the effects of the 2 farming methods, they brought in some rescued battery hens. Pupils set up live webcams, the egg cam and the pig cam, monitoring their livestock 24 hours a day. This enabled them to closely study how the animals behaved and how they changed.
They, you know, grow and mature and they get better, more healthy and things like that. It's nice to watch how they change from, you know, what intensive farming made them into the more extensive farming methods we use here.
The school encourages older pupils to support younger ones in their learning.
I don't want to take over, I just want to let them do what they want, but I'll tell them how to do it.
If they get stuck?
Yeah, if they're getting stuck, or if they want to know how to do this, I'll tell them, but then they can use that in their own way.
Do you like learning alongside older students? How does that work?
Because they have more experience.
And they can help us and stuff.
Yeah, if we get stuck, they just know what to do.
Obviously, the Recharge the Battery project was part of the science curriculum. Our science GCSE results have doubled in the last 3 years. And not just double, but there's a significantly higher number of higher attaining students as well, because they've been so inspired and enthused by it. And I think that is what you have to hold on to, that actually, yes, the children are attaining highly, but also they're developing fantastic, employable skills along with it, so they are becoming really good independent learners.
So if you want to embark on a pupil-led learning project, the staff and pupils of saltash.net Community School have got these tips. Really successful pupil-led learning requires teachers to take risks, and for this to happen, head teachers and senior management need to make it clear that they'll support staff and give them that freedom and backing. Don't intervene too much or take over the project from the pupils. Ask open questions to make the students think through the process themselves. And if pupils want to, let them use mobile phone and digital technology as part of their learning. Just give them clear guidelines on sensible use. If you want to learn more about sharing your great practice, just visit the Teachers TV website.